Annamacharya is perhaps one of those very rare composers who was at ease with highly classical Telugu, colloquial Telugu, folk Telugu, Sanskritized Telugu on one side, and Sanskrit of different styles on another. Annamacharya has never been an orthodox man, and his writings reveal that he was a revolutionary in more ways than one. He was born in a Smartha family and took to Vaishnavism, and all his later descendants have become Vaishnavites. His songs also reflect his rational thinking and liberal outlook. He does not believe in superstitious and dogmatic fallacies. This nature of Annamacharya is transparent even in his language, whether it is Sanskrit or Telugu. Out of the 14,000 and odd songs that are available today, there are hardly 100 compositions in Sanskrit. Scholars and critics consider some of them grammatically erroneous. Some of these songs are deceptively simple on the surface, but have a wealth of meaning embedded in them. It is amazing to see how Annamacharya combines formal and thematic elements to create lyrics of high art and religious intensity. There are many areas where we find Annamacharya defying the rules of grammar, sometimes even prosody and poetics. This only reflects not his lack of scholarship, but the density of his devotion and his exuberant emotional intensity. Mostly his Sanskrit compositions are Adhyatma Sankirtanas, devotional, spiritual lyrics. But the flavor of eroticism exists as fragrance in a flower in many of his Sanskrit compositions. There are about 3 or 4 songs in all his Sanskrit compositions which are a description of Alamelumanga, suffering the pangs of separation from the Lord, or Sringara Sankirtanas of the same purport. One of the most famous songs is Sakalam He Sakhi Janami. Incidentally, Annamacharya mentioned only 2 composers prior to him, Jayadeva and Krishnamacharya. Annamacharya mentions with reference Jayadeva's name in his Hymnody, a treatise on lyrical compositions entitled Sankirtana Lakshanam in Sanskrit. Unfortunately, this is not available to us, but fortunately the Telugu version, translated by his own grandson Chinnathirumalacharya, is available, titled Sankirtana Lakshanam. The author here says that he secured his father's permission to faithfully translate his grandfather's work into Telugu. One very significant aspect of this treatise on hymnody is that in this Annamaya praises the Gita Govinda compositions of Jayadeva in the 46th verse, and I quote, Ghanata miranga Jayadeva kavivarenyud andamainatti Gita Govinda mandu anchita ashtapadulu valkenatlu padamu varagu nenimidi padamulu pallaviyunu. The famous poet Jayadeva composed ashtapadis in his Gita Govindam, where the padam is endowed with a pallavi and 8 charanams. In the other erotic compositions, Annamacharya merges eroticism with devotion and love fights as worship. However intimate Alamelumanga may be to Venkateshwara, she knows that beyond a particular point, she cannot quarrel with him because he is God and not an ordinary person, nor she herself is a commoner. It becomes impolite to fight with the God even in love. Therefore she says, I know definitely I cannot be impolite. Therefore, O father of Cupid and the most handsome one, I quarrel with you every day, and that in itself is my daily worship. Nanu vinayokter na yogyaham. A close look at Annamacharya's compositions reveals his special attachment to Krishna. There are many compositions that he wrote on many gods, Rama, Krishna, Hanuman, Narasimha, Chanakeshava, Sri Ranganatha, and so on. While many of his songs relating to Narasimha, Hanuman, and Ranganatha are connected with deities at a particular pilgrim center, he did not compose on Rama and Krishna in that manner. His compositions on Rama and Krishna are devoid of their association with a particular pilgrim center. His temptation is transparent with respect to his compositions on Krishna. The largest number of compositions on any other god after Venkateshwara or on Krishna. Incidentally, even mythologically, Krishna is considered to be full-fledged incarnation of Vishnu. We find Krishna using Sudarshana Chakra and Panchajanyam the conch and the disc, which are Vishnu's weapons. In no other incarnation we find any of the weapons of Vishnu employed. There are also descriptions of Krishna even using Garuda as Vahana. There is a belief that when Annamacharya got married to two women simultaneously, he composed most of his erotic compositions then and thereafter, and he composed many songs on Balakrishna, lullabies, etc., after the birth of his children and during their childhood. We find a lot of brilliant compositions on Krishna in Sanskrit also. One such composition where he finds no difference between Vishnu and Krishna, Krishna and Venkateshwara, is set to Valaji by one of the greatest musicians of our time, late Sri Oleti Venkateshwarlu. The song runs like this: Kandarpa Janaka Garuda Gamana Nandagopatmaja Namo Namo. Father of Cupid, whose vehicle is Garuda, son of Nandagopa, salutations. One whose bed is the ocean, Vamana, Sridhara, Narasimha, Krishna, Namo Namo. One who has lotus in the navel, seen by the Vedas, Narayana, Hari, salutations. Absolute man, destroyer of worldly afflictions, bestower of boons, consort of Mother Earth, compassionate, dear to Kalindi, friend of Arjuna, Shauri, salutations. This song, Kandarpa Janaka Garuda Gamana, will now be presented.
Kandarpa Janaka Garuda Gamana, Kandarpa Janaka Garuda Gamana, Kandarpa Janaka Garuda Gamana, Kandarpa Janaka Garuda Gamana, Nanda Gopatmaja Namo Namo. Kandarpa Janaka Garuda Gamana, Nanda Gopatmaja Namo Namo. Kandarpa Janaka, ah, Varidhishayana Vamana Sridhara, Varidhishayana Vamana Sridhara, Narasimha Krishna Namo Namo. Varidhishayana Vamana Sridhara, Narasimha Krishna Namo Namo. Nirajanabha Nirajanabha Nigama Gochara, Nirajanabha Nigama Gochara, Nirajanabha Nigama Gochara, Narayana Hari, Narayana Hari, Narayana Hari, Namo Namo. Narayana Hari, Namo Namo. Kandarpa Janaka Garuda Gamana, Nanda Gopatmaja Namo Namo. Kandarpa Janaka, ah, 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 ah. Danava Damana Damodara, Danava Damana Damodara, Shashi Bhanu Nayana Balabhadranuja, Danava Damana Damodara, Shashi Bhanu Nayana Balabhadranuja, Dinarakshaka Dinarakshaka Sri Tiruvenkatesa, Dinarakshaka Sri Tiruvenkatesa. ಶೇಷ ನಾನಾ ಗುಣಮಯ ನಾನಾ ಗುಣಮಯ ನಾನಾ ಗುಣಮಯ ನಮೋ ನಮೋ ನಾನಾ ಗುಣಮಯ ನಮೋ ನಮೋ ಕಂದರ್ಪ ಜನಕ ಗರುಡ ಗಮನ ನಂದ ಗೋಪಾತ್ಮ ಜನಮೋ ನಮೋ ಕಂದರ್ಪ ಜನಕ ಆ